BS44, oh my god, sound speed.
Oh my god. Yeah. Alright.
Hi everybody, this is CVGS. I'm the captain here at Got Dempster.
Hi!
And today we have the new SD, not SD, this is the BS44. So this is the new booster pack. Demps, do you know the name?
This is Grand Walker's Beat or something like that.
Grand Walker's Beat. So this is the new set, the latest one that came out and introduces the Grand Walker Nexus, which you guys have seen in our SD unboxings for 43 and 44. So let's just look into what we have over here. Now, do you recognize the characters in the front, Dempster?
At the front, we have Lolo at the corner here. This is Apollon, and I think this is Apollo something. I forgot the name already, but it's a dragon that's related to Apollon.
Ah, I see. And then over here, we have the DPS Club.
Yep,
that's the only one that I know.
Alright, let's turn to the back and see if there's one more thing that you know, right? Okay, at the back, what do you have here?
I see Grand Walker Artemis.
Here.
Yeah, the other side, sorry.
Artemis is here. This is Ajit, if I'm not wrong. And these are the two spirits that are corresponding to their Grand Walker Nexus, as you can see.
Right.
So, as we mentioned, we keep mentioning Grand Walker Nexus. That's because the new Grand Walker Nexus will be in here as well for each different color, except for blue, yellow, green, and red. Blue, yellow, and green.
These
three colors.
Mm-hmm.
So we will. I'm not sure we're going to get that. And additionally, to celebrate the Battle Spirits 10th anniversary, there's a special rarity called 10x rare in here, which includes a card that is super super strong,
very very powerful, which includes one of the cards giving you an extra turn if you are able to pull off the skill.
Yep.
So there are three different types of x rares in here, and because there's the new rarity, I noticed they actually say on the side over here in each pack there's 9 cards inside. So I think they might have changed the rarity that you can get in this.
Yeah, as mentioned, there will be a 1.5 chance of getting a rare. So that means for every 2 packs, you get a third rare. Whether you get it or not, yeah, I don't know.
We'll see. So there's 60 packs in over here. So, right. So let's get inside. What's this that we have over here?
Oh,
this is a Battlespeed God Pack. So we don't know what's inside of here, but from our initial speculations, there are certain cards that we have seen that there might be in this pack exclusively. So it's a box topper. I think you only get one in each box, and it comes with one or four cards, which includes Grand Walker Roro.
Yep.
Which I believe is also there. But we go through this now. There are packs on the side here. So usual contest, whoever gets the most X-Rays between me and Dempster wins.
We're going with that again.
Let's actually set up a reward, shall we?
Reward, yeah, the winner will get to open this. How about?
The winner will get to open this God pack.
Oh my god pack.
Alright, so let's get started.
Alright, let's go.
Nine packs, it feels much more thicker now, so.
Yeah, like, duh.
Yeah, I know. But, you know, it's more prominent.
I got the first Master Rare, and it's a blue.
Oh, I also got the second Master Rare, and it's a purple. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. I think it's a Dark Thing.
Oh, no, it's a...
something else. Oh, okay.
Oh! I got a double X Rare!
Oh, cool!
The Grand World Dragon, Lolo Dragon. Grand Lolo Dragon! Okay, so I guess this pack will be mine
to open.
Yes.
Indeed. I got the X-ray over here. This is a green card for Blade Beast, I believe.
And because I got double X-ray, I don't have any more rest in this.
I see. I get double X, so it's
hey, Marco Zoro!
Hey, Marco Zoro reprint, so hey!
I need that! Oh, I got another Master Rare. This is Lyo Ayas.
Okay.
Oh, I got another X-ray.
Oh, wow.
Miladio.
Alright, I got a Master Rare over here. This is a Ancient Dragon Ray card. So,
where's my hand machines?
Oh, wait, no, they're not going to set.
Yeah.
It's all machine based.
Oh, that means we didn't get any Grand Walker. Oh, okay, we just got one. Apollon. There we go,
right there. So, since you've got the X-ray, so I guess you can just open it. Packs,
okay, sure.
Master Rare for this one.
Okay, it's a different one, but
I got a Grand Lolo Dragon, another one.
I see.
What the hell?
This is another one that I got from this pack here. And the last pack that I open up will be... hi. What are you? What are you indeed, so?
Oh, it's him! Heliosphere Dragon.
Heliosphere Dragon, interesting. Alright. Okay, that's all of it, so. Alright, so this is all the stuff that we open up from Master Race and above. So there's a lot of cards in BS44 that you can look up and much that you probably want to look forward to. So you can head over to the Facebook page World of Cards. There you can actually see the photo album for BS44 and you can see all the cards and their translator skills right over there. So let's go through the ones that we have over here. So we start with from my side over here. Now this is the double X rare. Dempster, what is it?
Yep, this is the world grand dragon.
Mm-hmm.
The grand great world dragon, I think. Grand Lolo Dragon.
Hmm.
So his skill is level 1, 2, 3, and 4 when this spirit is summoned. Summon one card from your hand, not named Grand Lolo Dragon, which is this one, with the family name, visitant, and avatar without by paying one cost.
Ah.
Second skill, release 2, level 2, 3, and 4 when this spirit attacks by sending 2 calls from your Grandwalker Nexus to this spirit. Refresh all of your spirits not named Grand Lolo Dragon, which is this one.
That's a very dangerous skill. Worthy of the X-Rare, I feel. So,
yep.
I can see a lot, because it's multicolored, so you can actually see a lot of use for this in multiple decks. So it's like the Alex of the Grandwalker era.
Yeah, and not just that, he's got a God Symbol, so he helps with reductions of a lot of spirits as well.
Uh-huh, that includes the God Symbol reduction. Moving on to the next one, this is the form that we got from the God Pack, right, Dempster?
Yeah.
Yeah, so what is it?
This is also Grand Lolo Dragon, but this is a World Young Dragon or something like that.
Yeah.
Alright, his skill, level 1 and 2, when this spirit is summoned, you may open the top 3 cards of your deck. Then add one card among them that is a Grandwalker Nexus to your hand. Then the rest get sent to the bottom in any order you like. Then after resolving this effect, by paying one cost, you can activate this effect once again.
Haha, yes.
Yep. Not bad, huh? Not bad.
Not
you
can bad indeed, sir.
Okay, second skill, release 1, level 2, when this spirit attacks once per turn. By sending one call from your Grandwalker Nexus to this spirit, you can activate your Grand skill, your Grandwalker's Nexus Grand skill as if you have already paid one cost. So you pay one less for the Grand skill.
Mm-hmm. And there are some Grand skills that are actually very, very powerful, even more so if you have it less. Paid by that way lah. So this one is a very, very powerful card. And it's such a cheap card as well. 2 cost. Very powerful. So I'm now very scared.
No, you know what you need?
What?
A thesaurus for powerful. Because we have a lot of other cards that are just like that.
That is true. I do need a thesaurus for powerful. So the next one that we have here,
it's also a powerful card.
It's also a powerful card. It's a mighty, mighty card over here.
Oh, nice.
This
nice,
is the Grand Walker Apollo. So to explain what the Grand Walker Nexus is, so this Nexus cannot be affected by effects that target a Grand Walker Nexus. Cards can only be placed on this Nexus by effects from core charge and or effects that target a Grand Walker Nexus. Cards cannot be moved except by effects that target a Grand Walker Nexus. Alright, so its skills that it has is core charge for Astro Dragon, Visitant, or Avatar, and cost 3 or more. So when you summon or descend a listed spirit, you can add one call from the void to this Nexus. When this Nexus is deployed, if there are no other Grandwalker Nexus with the same name, send the top 3 cards of your deck to the trash. For each listed card, send one call from the void to the Nexus. The listed card being the races that I mentioned. The rest of the skill that it has is that level 1, level 2, this Nexus's symbol is also treated as red.
Okay.
So it's both a God symbol and a red. Its grand skill, 2, level 1, level 2, on flash timing during both players' attack step, by sending 2 calls from this Nexus to the void, by destroying one opposing spirit ultimate with BP 6000 or lower, you get to draw one card from your deck. Then it's grand field skill, level 2, during your attack step, when your spirit from the family Astro Dragon destroys an opposing spirit or ultimate, send one call from your opponent's life to your opponent's reserve. This effect cannot be duplicated. So this Grand Walker Nexus, once you activate its Grand Field at level 2, which I believe the number of cards you need is 5, you can immediately shoot one of your opponent's life into the reserve.
Oh, wow.
Just by destroying one of your opponent's opposing spirits or ultimates, which is a very, very dangerous, dangerous card.
No wonder everyone uses this card.
Yes.
Okay.
Hold me, I'm scared.
You cannot see if I'm holding myself right now.
Yes, but what is the card that you're holding, Dempster?
Okay, this is the Water something Angelia. Mm. Miladiel.
Ooh.
Nice name, right?
Very nice
name. It's a radiant descent, cost 6 and above, and has to be a divine spirit. So, level 1, 2, 3, when this spirit attacks or blocks, send 3 calls from the void to your life.
Mm.
Then after that, この効果はゲーム中に, you can only use this effect once per game.
Oh.
It's a strong skill that demands that kind of restriction.
Strong. Okay.
Level 2 and 3, when this spirit attacks, by you send one call from the life to this spirit. If you do that, refresh this spirit and send one opposing spirit to the bottom of the deck.
Huh.
It's actually quite simple, but it's it plays so much with Holy Life, which is a skill that has been prevalent for the yellow side since the beginning of Battle of Spirits.
Mm.
Holy Life is one of those skills where you send calls from the void to your life, and then you can use those calls as cost to do something. Like in this case, you send it to your this spirit. You can level her up at the same time, and at the same time, right, she refreshes again. And you can continue the attack, and you also deplete your opponent's field.
That seems very fair, actually, as a game mechanic. Which
it is.
This is one fantastic.
But the problem is whether you can get her out in the first place.
Yeah, it is true. That is true. She is a cost 8, and while she does have Radiant Descent, it's still a very high cost to Radiant Descent upon. So, all right. Yeah. Moving on to the next card that you have over there on the right. Mm-hmm. What is that, Nems?
This is a 7 Great Hero Beast, the Whirlwind King. Achilles. So it's a radiant descent. The condition is Blade Beast and cost 6 and above.
Mm.
So level 1, 2, 3. This spirit cannot be affected by opposing spirits, ultimates, and nexuses.
Next side.
Level 2 and 3. When this spirit attacks, by heavy exhausting one opposing spirit, refresh this spirit.
Oh, indeed. That is scary. Now, Blade Beast is actually new for green, right?
No, it's been around for a while, but it's got a lot stronger now.
Oh, okay, I see. That is kind of scary. So, And then there's another Blade Beast that we have over here. Oh, this is a burst card. What is it, Ems?
Yep, this is a Hero Beast. A cheetah, I don't know what it means. Lyo Ayas.
Oh, okay.
So, okay, this one has no Radiant Descent, but it's fine.
Mm?
So, when you have a Blade Beast in your trash, this card cannot be affected by opponent effects while set. Why set? Because it has a burst effect. So the condition is when your opponent activates when this spirit is summoned or descends skill. Exhaust 3 opposing spirits. Then after the effect resolves, summon this card without paying the cost.
Uh-huh.
Level 1, 2, 3, when this spirit is summoned, send one opposing exhausted spirit to the bottom of the deck.
Hmm.
Level 2 and 3, when this spirit attacks, your opponent cannot activate the burst.
I'm getting shivers up my spine right now.
No, you don't have to worry. You just set you if you know your opponent's playing this, you set this as well on your side, then both block each other. Oh, yo, I cannot activate burst, huh? Got you. Right.
Yeah,
got you.
When you think about it, yeah, that is yeah, insane.
Or one more answer is Alex.
Oh, one more answer is also Alex as well. Alright, the next card that we have here, I'll take this from here then. Mm-hmm. So this is a purple card, the Undead Scorpion King.
Mene Scorpio.
Alright, so it's effect level 1, level 2, level 3. When this spirit is summoned or attacks, return one spirit from the family Dark Snake to your in your trash back to your hand.
Oh.
Then destroy one opposing exhausted spirit. Wow. Okay.
Wait, is this a Dark Snake?
Yeah, it's a Dark Snake.
No wonder.
So level 2, level 3, during your main step, once per turn by sending one call from one of your cards with the name Graham Walker Osiris to the void, you get to exhaust one of your opponent's spirits.
Oh.
So you will use him getting up to level 2, then use his skill to remove a call from Graham Walker Osiris to exhaust.
Mm-hmm.
And then when he attacks or when he's summoned, then you get to destroy one opposing exhausted spirit. This is a good way to snipe out any of your opponent's key cards, actually. So
except if they have heavy armor or ultra armor.
Hey,
cough, now, cough, white.
Hey, I heard that there's actually a heavy super armor now.
Yes, there is. So as a punishment, you're not getting any white cards. Alright, next card. Cap, what do you have?
Alright, so the next card that I have here, Dems, can you take the name for me?
Okay, this is Lycoryu Valivaz
Oh, okay. So the English name is the name is the Lightning Roaring Dragon, Varivas.
Yep.
So its effect is level 1, level 2, level 3. When this spirit is summoned, you destroy one opposing spirit ultimates with 20,000 BP or lower. Holy hell. Hmm? All the cores on the spirit ultimate that was destroyed by this effect is sent to the trash instead of the reserve. Holy hell.
Wow.
Wow, Thunder Dragon 2. Beyond would definitely love this card. It's another skill, level 2, level 3. When this spirit attacks, by sending two cores from your Red Grandwalker Nexus to the void, during your opponent's refresh step, your opponent cannot return any cores from their trash back to their reserves.
Oh, wow. That's the ultimate block there, man.
It is the ultimate block. The only saving grace is that it's not a Radiant Descent, so there's no easy way of getting this card out. It has 2 God Symbol reduction as well as 4 red, so...
Yeah, but there are ways to summon things up being a cost or by being one cost, right? So it almost makes no difference.
Very true. So it's a very, very scary card, but I don't know what's going on over there.
All right, the last card that we have, what is it, Cap?
This is the Sun Emperor Heliosphere.
Heliosphere Dragon.
Heliosphere,
they missed it.
Dragon, so,
alright.
So, its effect is that when you summon a spirit from the family Astral Dragon, you can summon this spirit as a cost 4 from your hand.
Oh, okay, wow.
Wow, indeed. So, it's skill level 1, level 2, level 3. During the start of your attack step, send any number of cores, except your soul core, from the trash onto this spirit. If 5 or more cores were sent, destroy one opposing spirit with 10,000 BP or lower.
Ah.
Alright, level 2, level 3. When this spirit attacks or blocks, destroy one opposing spirit with BP lower than this spirit. Okay. And this one has a maximum BP of 12,000. So.
Yep. Alright, I would just want to point something out first here, that this is a key card that is used by a lot of Astral Dragon players in Limited Building Battle for Extreme Game. The Red Guardian is using it, some of the people are using it as well. This is a key card. That means Leon must not touch it, and we will expect to see a lot of Astro Dragons as well as Heliosphere Dragon and some other, probably Apollon as well, in the upcoming tournaments to come.
Indeed.
So good luck to us. Good luck to good luck to Machine Beast. Good luck to Blade Beast. Good luck to Dark Snake. We are all gonna die.
And rest in peace, our machine.
And rest in peace, Blue, because no one talks about it. And Jelias also, no one talks about them.
Hopefully, we're going to talk about it soon in the next box.
But for now,
if you guys want to see the other cards that's also in this set as well, a reminder, do head over to the Facebook page World of Cards. There you can actually see the album for BS44 as well as the previous sets that's been released so far, and you can check the translations over there. And yeah, pretty much that's it from us over here. So if you like what you see here and want to see all these cards in action soon, do subscribe to us here at CVGS. Ring the bell so you can get notified of all of our videos whenever it comes out. Follow us on all our socials, Facebook, Twitter. We have a blog, crossbowvanguards.com. There you can find some of our stuff over there. Join us on Discord as well, so you can find myself, Dempster, all the other Vanguards there. We're there most nights. And last but not least, if you like what you see here and want to support the show directly, do consider supporting us over on Patreon. The links are in the description box below. With that said, thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!
Hold me, Dempster.
Hold me tight, don't let me go.